returning from the moon. We left our Hadley base right on time. One moment we were sitting on the surface. The next moment we were 100 meters in space, looking down at the place where we had camped for 3 days. I could see the descent stage, our scientific station, the tracks of our car. I could almost imagine that I could see those boot prints that would be there for a million years. It was there that the Lord had touched my life anew. Would I be able to achieve that closeness to the Lord on the earth? These were the feelings as we sped to our rendezvous with the command module. Now we made preparations to leave the moon. As we looked back toward Earth, it was only a thin crescent. Why, it looked more like the moon than the Earth. We established a precise trajectory for home. Then a time for a spacewalk. The door was open and Al Warden floated out. I hung in the open doorway as a safety observer. Al later reflected that this was the most spectacular sight on the mission. Jim Irwin suspended in space. Behind me was a full moon. In the opposite direction was the crescent Earth. It was an unusual feeling for me to be simply hanging there when we were traveling at 10,000 miles per hour. Suspended between the full moon and the crescent Earth, I felt I was an alien. I welcomed the opportunity to enter the familiar spacecraft and close the door. Arrival Earth. As we approached the Earth, the crescent of light gradually faded, so the Earth now became completely dark. We did not see the beautiful colors of Earth until we sped into sunlight over the Pacific. Then I looked out my window and could see the snow-capped mountains of New Zealand on the horizon. Now I knew I was coming home. There was the tremendous pressure as we were slowed by the atmosphere of Earth. Then the heart-stopping moment when the parachute failed. We were falling too fast. Would we have enough time to accomplish all that was necessary before we hit the water? Coming back on two chutes and a prayer. We were anticipating a hard impact, and we're not disappointed. So good to be back on the Earth. I felt very comfortable lying in the spacecraft and watching the waves against the window. It wasn't long before the frogmen opened the hatch and the fresh sea breeze swept in. The air felt so good. I knew I was home. We were lifted one by one into the helicopter. We were given clean clothes so we might look more presentable for our welcome. In just a short time, we landed on the deck of the aircraft carrier. The red carpet was out. We staggered a bit as we were greeted by congressmen and military officers. We felt the motion of the ship, but there was the unusual feeling of gravity. We stepped to the microphone to speak to the waiting world. Dave spoke first, then Al, and now it was my turn. There wasn't much left to be said but to express gratitude. I thank the team who had worked with us so closely, the American people who had paid for our voyage, the people around the world who had prayed for us, and then I thank God who had given us another successful mission to the moon.